Hello and welcome to the Talk the Untalked show, and I am Deepali. Today in conversation is an extremely eminent producer of the Indian film industry with 5 world records to his credit, the founder of the Noida Film City and the recipient of the prestigious Dada Saheb Phalke Film Foundation Award for his immense contribution to cinema, Mr. Sandeep Marwah.
So it is such an honor to be sitting in front of you here. You have such a stronghold in the Indian film industry. How do you think have movies evolved over the year?
Well, it's a beautiful setup. Indian film industry is the biggest film industry in the world. We make around about 2,000 films in a year. We have around about 12,000 theaters in this country. We sell something like 5 billion tickets every year. And 15 million people watch cinema every day. Right. It's more than the population of Hungary and many other European countries. So you can well imagine that handling such a huge, big setup in 29 states and 7 union territories of India is not a joke. And I think even after that, Indian film industry is growing day by day. The major film industry is Hindi film industry, followed by then we have Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam, and then followed by every state. So I think this kind of a movie setup you will never find anywhere in the world.
Correct. So you just talked about how Telugu and Tamil cinema is doing wonderful. We had a movie called Bahubali which had huge numbers. It has made massive records. How do you feel as a producer, since it's such a big production, and how do you feel as a fellow producer of the industry too?
The fact is that I have specialized in short films. That's my forte, and I have created a world record for myself by producing 2,600 short films, and I have given opportunity to around 10,000 filmmakers, around 2,600 directors from more than 100 countries of the world. And that has become a separate account. But when you come back to these kind of films, I think they are extraordinary. People in our industry, they have gone out of way to invest money. They have learned the tricks of the trade. Marketing has become much better than what it used to be. And probably that's the reason that 2 films which have done extraordinary well all over the world, one obviously the Dangal and second Bahubali. And imagine that
internationally.
Oh yes, they are doing extraordinary well. And I think people have learned in the industry that if your product is beautifully designed, very well carved, with a fantastic and a binding story, then trust me, it has an international market, because you can comfortably dub your film in any language.
So how you just talking about the product entirely. These days, if we talk about movies, movies are majorly content driven. We talk about the fact that content is the king, and how even if you have a star in the movie, it is not the defining factor these days. It's all about the content, whether or not your story speaks for the movie.
Absolutely.
So what do you have to say about that?
I think this is absolutely a correct statement, and I've been shouting, and I'm all the time looking for writers. I'm very happy that some of my students who have done extraordinarily well again in industry, only because these young guys came out with something unique, something extraordinary, something which has not been written or shown on screen ever. Rajat Arora, which has done extraordinarily well, and then there is another student who has done very well. I mean, I've been getting reports, and you need to be out of the box. You have to think something which has not been shown, and you will win the game. You will win the game, because people, let's say in India, they have seen hundreds of film. Don't forget that even today, film is the most popular source of entertainment for Indians. Okay. So they don't leave they don't spare any film.
Okay.
But then what they're looking for, something new. Same story will obviously make them bore, and they don't want to come back again to theater.
Right.
So I think we're working on it. I have gone out of way to start a story writing and a screenwriting course in my university, and I'm sure we will be able to produce some more wonderful writers soon.
So these days, if we consider filmmaking as a profession, there is a new acceptance, and there are so many people who are in pursuit of getting into the film industry, not only as actors but also as directors, as cinematographers, as movie writers. So what do you have to say about this sudden flow of people who are more interested and may also be also as a profession? Do you also think that having filmography integrated within our own education and maybe a vocational course would also help people to discover this field as well?
Now, you imagine 26 years back, I got into education.
Right.
And I was that time a bit unique because I was the first person to start a film school in private sector. We were fourth in India, but we were first in private sector. The earlier three, they belonged to Government of India, and all of them were actually doing very bad. They were not in a good condition that time. And I'm happy that there was a channel invasion, and I was at the right time, and we could establish ourselves from 50 students, 5 courses, to 5,000 students and 55 courses. It's a beautiful journey of 26 years which proves itself that there is a demand, there is a requirement, there is a need, there is an increasing passion for films, television and media. But it has taken me 25 years to propagate from city to city, state to state, country to country. And let me talk about my own country rather. Probably I've been to so many schools, colleges, events, setups, just to propagate that this is a beautiful business.
Right.
And today I'm so happy that in the span of all these years, media and entertainment industry has become the sixth biggest industry in India. And we are touching almost 200,000 crore rupees turnover.
Wow.
So it's not a joke. Somebody wants to give me a credit, fine. It doesn't matter to me. But I'm very happy that the industry has grown. Requirements have grown. Don't forget that today we have 950 channels in India. I mean, it's not a joke. And all these channels are giving almost 24 hours program. We need 100,000 hours of program every year. Who's going to make it? Not the walls, not the camera alone. You need trained manpower.
Right.
And I think that these statistics clearly shows that the passion, the interest for this industry has grown from where it was to somewhere which you could not even think about.
Yeah.
So I'm very happy about this. And Noida Film City itself was quite a tough job for me. When I designed in 1986, I was almost declared a madman. People thought that 86, UP, Film City, there was no culture, there was no interest of the people, there was no support. And people were reluctant even about talking about it.
Right.
Cut down to 2019. Today, Noida Film City is the fastest growing film city in the world. It's a 100-acre complex, 75 acres outdoor, 25 acres indoor, 16 studios. And out of 16 studios, 400 channels are being broadcast, 262 countries, 24/7. Approximately 16,000 to 17,000 media professionals, they're working in Film City in 3 shifts of 8 hours each. The cascading effect is probably 150,000 people, they're earning their bread because of Noida Film City. And I'm very happy when people call me founder of Noida Film City. I'm happy, at least I could do something worthwhile for my nation.
So since you envisioned it, what do you think, what is your vision for the next 10 years of our film industry going? So you, in 86, how you started and you could envision it to be doing wonders in future. What do you think at this stage would movie making or Indian film industry do in future?
See, I believe in statistics also because they are the measuring sticks and they teach you that which direction you are. If it's reducing, that means you are on the wrong side. If they're increasing, that means you're on the right side. And I'm very happy that all the 16 studios in Noida Film City are doing very well. And after 16 studio, probably 600 studios have come up in NCR, including one yours.
Yeah.
And the fact is this, that people they want to get associated with this beautiful industry because there is a kick in this industry. There's a huge charm in this industry and you need it. There was a time when a trained personnel used to only look upon film industry, then to television industry. Now, my dear, don't forget that every government department, every private company, every multinational company, every event which is happening on this earth need a media setup. And you need media professionals. You need a trained guy to handle all these shows. And from that stage to mobile. Now, people may not be knowing much, but then 13 years back, I made the first film in India on mobile.
Okay.
And I started the first ever festival of mobile cinema in India. That was the first one in the world.
All right.
And I'm so happy that I have been titled as father of mobile cinema.
Okay.
And I'm carrying this title, and we have started a festival in New York. We have this year I've started festival in Hungary. The best part is that only 2 months back I was in Cannes. We have started a festival in Cannes.
Wow.
And I have brought obviously my award from Cannes. Not many Indians have been honored in Cannes, by the way.
Right. So, sir, what do you think about the paradigm shift that's happening into the digital space these days?
Ultimate. The digital has brought filmmaking from studios to school classrooms.
Do you think it's going to hamper the fact that people might restrict themselves to this digital media, and it might reduce the footfalls into the movies?
No, not at all. You're reminding me a question which probably some journalist asked me 20 years back, that what will happen if there'll be a internet?
Right.
Now, if you go back, feature film which used to be on celluloid, until when television came in, television invasion, 1 to 400 channels, people thought cinema will go. Mm-hmm. It's a dead end for it. But no, television became complementary to cinema.
Correct, yeah.
When internet came and a small screen, when your laptops or your desktops came in, people thought now you can watch your film sitting back in your office at your home. So probably the big screen will go. Mm-hmm. No, it didn't. Internet became complementary to television and cinema.
Right.
When mobile came in, and now it's a huge market for mobile cinema, but still films are films. Now they can take a different shape. Mm-hmm. Probably the theater size have been reduced, they have become more lucrative. Theaters are providing you extraordinary facilities to invite you back to the theaters. Theaters are in multiplexes, mm-hmm. so that you can have multiple action when you're entering into a mall, film and your day-to-day purchases. So all these things are slowly and gradually changing because digital has become. And the best part is that the whole filmmaking has been converted into digital. Celluloid is finished. Mm. There is no negative left today. Mm. Every film is being shot on digital. So digital will remain now for many years. The more new technologies will come in, the projections have become so powerful, music has become so terrific. When you enter into a hall, the way you enjoy a film, trust me, you cannot enjoy on mobile.
Correct.
You cannot enjoy on your home's television set or a laptop.
Mm.
So I think it will remain there. It is going to be a mother of all entertainments, and big screen has a different charm.
Right. So just being a part of the film industry, what according to you is good cinema?
Well, thank God you asked good cinema. Good cinema is one which should leave good impact on the audience.
Okay.
Good cinema is one which is able to entertain you.
Hmm.
And good cinema is one when you leave the theater, it has to come out from your mouth, okay, wow, I enjoyed.
Right.
There is no other definition. Every filmmaker tries to put in his best while making a film. You spend crores of rupees in making one good film.
Mm.
You advertise, you market your film, you pay so much money to so many people, you deal with almost 35 different departments of making a film. You spend your blood, soul into cinema. Nobody is trying to make a bad cinema.
Right.
It is entirely up to the audience what they like. There are times when something which is good for someone may be a bad for someone.
Mm.
But on the whole, you have to see the efforts, the target, what we are trying to through this films. Mm. And at least when you talk about Indian cinema, every film is theme-oriented.
Correct.
Down the line, a filmmaker tries his level best to leave at least one good message to the audience.
Right.
Because cinema has always been the biggest source of communication on this earth.
So you, the way you were just talking about how there has to be a message. So there, recently there have been a couple of movies where the message, so-called the message wasn't correct. There was a huge hue and cry. So say a movie such as Kabir Singh that was recently released, and there was a massive hue and cry about the fact that the message wasn't correct. It was a little misogynistic, and it wasn't imparting the correct message, or it might have a bad influence on the viewers. Do you think it is the responsibility of a filmmaker to have a correct message being imparted so that the influence does not lead to maybe just influencing the mindsets?
No. See, you're a little confused. The fact is that probably the film started in a very irritating way,
yeah,
but at the end of the day, it's still leaving a message. It's very important to understand that if there is no Ravana, there is no Ram.
Okay.
Remember that. The value of Ram will be zero, mm-hmm, if there is no Ravana. So, unless and until you show negativity, how you will learn the positivity?
Okay.
So, even a film like this leaves a lot of impact that you have to be very careful about your children from the beginning.
Okay.
You have to see to it that your children should have a right aptitude. They've been given right knowledge, right culture. So, all these things, you learn from all these things, I think.
Okay.
And responsibility the filmmaker is, no doubt about it, to leave something good through cinema.
So did it never strike you to come on screen?
Well, I tried once, and then I signed three films with the three leading heroines of one time when I wanted to be in films.
Mm.
And they, unfortunately, they were getting very late, and I felt so restless. But during all that time, I realized that probably I have something more to do.
Mm.
I realized that acting is it's just one part of filmmaking,
right.
One. And second, it's you have to be so self-centered. And probably my attitude and aptitude is that I'm meant for public, I'm meant for masses,
right.
I'm meant for service. And that's how probably I got into making of a Noida Film City, making of now a university. I'm chairing probably 100 different film, television, media, art, culture, social organizations. I'm wearing different caps at a different time, and I'm happy about that because it keeps me busy 24 hours, and it has given me ample opportunity to develop cinema, to develop art and culture, and to amalgamate art and culture with the whole world.
Right.
And I'm very happy that I have been titled as a global cultural minister,
wow,
which I'm carrying within. I'm lucky that more than 50 countries of the world, they have nominated me as the cultural ambassador or brand ambassador of their country in India. I'm so thankful to each and every country, the president of the countries, for giving me so much of honor, love, respect, and I'm very busy. I'm very busy in developing art and culture and relations. I make around about 400 events in a year, and the idea is to bring in best of the people possible on platform, ask them to share their ideas, experience, their ways, and everything is a part of cinema also.
So where do you think our Indian cinema stands in comparison to the world cinema, if you compare it with the other?
We are the best. We are the best. How can I say that we are not? The fact is that such a huge industry, And it's one, that it's the biggest source of entertainment. Okay. Second, it has given the whole media and entertainment industry, art and culture, it has given employment to almost 6 million people.
Correct.
Don't forget about that. Third, that if there is no media and entertainment, your life is dull. There will be no enthusiasm in life. Imagine that. And in comparison to many other countries, the fact is that we are the biggest, we are the largest. I have just come back from Korea. I was in, last week I was in Uzbekistan, last month I was in Azerbaijan, before that I was in Italy, so before that I was in Cannes in France. I'm amazed the way people treat Indian film industry. They have so much of love, so much of respect, and they look Indian filmmakers so high. And this only you can realize once you are there. Talking, criticizing, abusing Indian film industry and not giving enough prominence or status to Indian film industry, probably this is everything in India. But the minute you are out of this country, you will be raised. You are on the heaven.
Okay.
I have gone as a chief guest in all these countries. I have covered so many countries, and as a filmmaker first, I've always been treated filmmaker first, and probably then a social worker or educationist. And I was in Nigeria. I was in Senegal. You can't even imagine. I mean, I would love to narrate an instance. When I was in Senegal, I attended 5 conferences in 5 days. I was a state guest, and Minister of Culture and Tourism was with me all the time. And our honorable, our ambassador was all the time with me, being a state guest. And every function, when it used to finish, people used to come and touch me.
Okay.
And 1, 2, 3, and a fourth time I asked the minister, I say, what is this custom that you touch your chief guest or something like that after the function? He says, no, I've never seen before in my life. So he invited people from the public and asked them in his own language that, what is this? Why are you coming and touching our chief guest like this?
Okay.
And those people said that this is the first time in Senegal any film person has come, and we are touching Mr. Marwah so that we can tell our coming generations that we touched a man from Bollywood.
Wow.
Can you imagine? I swear the tears were in my eyes. I was touched by such a beautiful gesture, and what a statement. This is the level of impact of Indian cinema abroad.
Since Indian cinema is so revered, what do you think are some of the apprehensions before you produce a movie as a producer? What do you think are some of the movies if in case it does not align with your own school of thought?
No. See, point is that films are not made just like that.
Right.
You have to do a lot of research. You have to write the script, and probably you have to rewrite the script 7 times.
Right.
You have to have characters in mind. You have to develop each and every character from beginning till end. You have to also keep the star cast in mind, whether this character is suiting that person or not. And then you will sometime rewrite your script. Suppose if you have opted for A character, then probably you have to take his mannerism, his setup, his figures, his body, his mind, his aptitude also into the character. And that's how films are made. The initial part, which is called pre-production, is the most important part in filmmaking. And if your research is good, your characterization is good, your selection of artist is good, then probably you get into a filmmaking. And all these things take about 6 months to 1 year.
Okay.
So you need a lot of hard work even before shooting the film.
Right.
And shooting itself is a different subject now. Production is one, and then obviously post-production.
Sir, you've been a part of this industry for the longest time. Now, we have the longest debate. Whenever you talk about cinema, there's this longest debate about the fact that it is an easier access if in case you're in cinema and then your own son or your daughter's there. Since Mohit Marwah is already a part of this industry, what do you have to say about this bad word, nepotism, that we all talk about?
See, it's everywhere.
Right.
First, tell me, who would not like to see his own daughter and son to be settled in life? So simple is that. So someone who's in cinema, his specialization in that business, obviously would like his son and daughter to settle, because he spent so many years in building up contacts, building up a business. Why not? And this is everywhere. And an industrialist would like to see to it that his son should come and join his business.
Right.
And anything and everything. When it comes to Mohit Marwah, I'm very happy. A very hardworking and a very honest boy who's very well trained and groomed in acting. He's a product of Asian Academy of Film and Television. He's also done his beautiful training at Lee Strasberg College in New York. And he's been an assistant to Vikram Bhatt, where he has directed four films with him. He has worked from scratch to the assistant director. Everything of filmmaking he has seen. And I never stopped him because I wanted him to be groomed and learn every trick of the trade. Though education at AFT is very powerful, it's absolutely practical. We have ample to talk about industry when it comes to AFT and its classes and courses. But then obviously he wanted to learn every trade, because at the end of the day, he is also an educationist. I would love to see him as a head of the Asian Education Group. And you can only be a head of Asian Education Group if you have been totally groomed. You know each and every segment, each and every department, each and every segment of filmmaking. Then you are a good trainer and an educator. And so I'm very happy that he has been trained as an educator, trained as been as a filmmaker, and trained as an actor. He's played so far a wonderful role. He's been a brand ambassador for Provoke. He's done his short film with Yash Chopra Camp. He's done his short film with Karan Johar. Then he has done his major role in feature film Fugly, where he was one of the lead rather. He's done his second lead in Fugly, after Fugly, Raag Desh.
Okay.
And that was the first film ever been made by Rajya Sabha, which is also a wonderful status. He's won his national award for his film Raag Desh. And I think it's pretty good. He's now waiting for a right script. And I'm sure in just due course of time, you will be seeing him in his new avatar and new film.
We're really waiting, sir. Thank you so much for being with us. It was such an honor talking
to you. Pleasure talking to you.
Thank you so much.